Hey everyone, thanks for checking out the video. I'm really excited about this one because it's the second video of my Teach All the Plugins in Logic long series. It's not a short series, there's a lot of plugins. Last week's video was on the sample delay plugin, which was a simple plugin to get started, and I thought no better to follow that up than the standard channel EQ in Logic. That's a great place to start when learning the plugins, and I'm gonna get right to it. If that all sounds good, make sure you like and subscribe, hit the notification bell. It really helps the channel to grow and helps other people find these videos so they can learn from them. Okay, here we go. To get to the channel EQ, go right here, go down to Logic, go to EQ, go to channel EQ. You're gonna have options for mono, stereo, or dual mono, depending on what channel you have. So I'm gonna choose stereo for the most of this video, and then we'll talk about mono and stereo applications at the end. Channel EQ, what is it? It's an EQ, surprise. If that was a plot twist for you, I don't know. It's an 8-band EQ more specifically. And so some EQ plugins have switchable bands where you can pick like, I want this to be a bell or this to be a shelf. Logic doesn't have that. Instead, it just gives you a bunch of bands. So all the way across the top here, you've got your 8 different bands. So you've got the low cut or high pass, your low shelf, you've got 4 mid bands going all the way up. Then you have a high shelf and then a high cut or a low pass. So that's a ton of options. That's a lot more than most EQs. Some of them will make you pick, like they'll give you 2 mid bands and then a low and a high, and you have to pick between shelf or bell. This gives you both. So it already has a ton of options just right out the gate. So along the top here, each band is represented by a color, and that color corresponds to a dot on the screen here. And that all corresponds to these parameters down here. So it's kind of this linear view. So down here in the controls section, the top control on every band is the frequency. So like where the cut or boost or change is going to occur. Below that, you have the steepness of your filter. On all the other bands that aren't filters, you have your cut and boost. So depending on what you're using, that control is gonna be a little different. And then the bottom one is your Q factor or the width of your band. So for example, if I push up this band here, you can do the Q factor like that and change the width there. That's what you have across the board for every band. You can click the top of each band to toggle them on and off. So if you want to A/B it without a certain frequency or something, you can run through here, click them all on and off. That's a really helpful feature. You can also click and drag right on there. You don't have to go down to the parameters. Click, drag right on here to move it around. But if you want to type in a certain, say I want 500 and only 3 dB, you can type that in as well. Whatever is easiest for you there. Then to change the Q, like while you're dragging around on here, you can do option click and drag, and you'll get this little Q icon, and you can adjust the Q right there. So like dial in your band, dial in the Q, you're done, super quick. And then if you wanna reset a certain band, completely zero it out, you can hit option click. So that'll put it back at its default location, put it at 0, reset the Q. That's also really nice to, if you did some cuts or boosts and it sounds terrible, just put it back. Down here along the bottom, these are more like utility tools and stuff. The analyzer, that's gonna show you the frequencies. So if you wanna mix with your eyes, you can turn it on. And if you wanna mix with your ears, you can turn it off. Just kidding. It's helpful to have on, but it's good to know that you have the option to toggle it right there. And then the pre and post button means, is it gonna show you what's happening before the EQ, or is it gonna show you what's happening after the EQ? So pre means before you have applied EQ, like this is where it's at coming into the EQ. Post means this is where it's at after you've done all the cuts and boosts. So I'll go ahead and hit play. I've got a drummer track pulled up. Okay, so right now analyzer is off. Here it is on. So we can see our snares hitting at 200. It's great. If I push this way up, now you see 200 has climbed significantly. If I turn it to pre, you can see where 200 was coming in before. So here's post, way up there, pre. That's what that means. Q couple, this is a really cool feature. So basically, Q couple means as you change the gain, it's gonna adjust the Q proportionately, so you get the same perceived amount of width, like frequency width. So basically, let's use this one as an example. Let me reset it. As I pull it up, you'll see that it kind of gets a little narrower. And then especially you can see it when you pull it down, the cue gets thinner as it goes down. And that just helps provide a more natural response, natural sound. Not all EQs do that, but you have the option to toggle it off. So now if I turn off cue couple and pull this down, it's gonna be that same exact cut all the way down. Same thing with the boost, all the way up. So here's cue couple on, you push it up and you can see it getting narrower as you push it up. Play around with this and see what you like. Each one yields a very different sound. And so depending on the style you're going for, cue couple on is definitely more surgical on the cuts. So if you're trying to remove a very specific frequency, I'd recommend the cue couple. If you want that analog kind of feel, you might want to turn it off because it's going to be those bigger like moves. Just be careful with it if it's off because it's really easy to just pull the entire frequency spectrum out of your channel. The HQ button here, it enables oversampling. I've actually never turned this on. I had to look it up for the sake of the video. Basically, this helps to maintain smoothness on the top end if you're boosting like large amounts. It'll oversample it and help your computer like deal with that. I usually leave it off. If I need to boost like a crazy amount on the highs, I'll usually reach for a colored EQ or I'll address the thing that I'm recording if I can and see like, what's going on? Why do I need to add 15 dB to the top? But generally, to me, that's not what the channel EQ is for. The channel EQ is a really clean surgical EQ for a lot of generic tasks. But if you need something like that, I would just grab a different EQ. There's other vintage EQ collection within Logic. That would be a lot better for boosting lots of top because it kind of has that color, that analog feel. I would just be careful with that. That's all I'm saying. But that's what the HQ does. It enables that oversampling. The next thing is this processing. And so now we're getting into stereo stuff. If you pull up a mono version of the plugin, you're not going to have that option. So this is only in the stereo operation. Basically, this is setting what your channel EQ is affecting. And so the majority of the time, you will want your stereo EQ affecting the stereo, the left and right together. If you go down here though, you can affect just the left side only, just the right side only. And this is helpful if there's like a hi-hat or something you wanna bring some brightness up on. So our hi-hat's over on the right. So I could set this on the right. And just boost on the right, kind of get a little more hi-hat over there. So that's one way you can use it. Mid only. This gets into mid-side processing, which basically means the stuff uniquely in the center channel is mid, and the stuff on the side channels that's not uniquely in the center, that's sides. So a good example of mid was gonna be like kick drum, snare drum, that kind of thing. A good example of sides is gonna be toms, hi-hats, room mics, that kind of thing. So for kick drum only, I'm gonna try to find the low end of the kick and boost that, and we're not gonna be boosting on the sides, which is really convenient. So I'll switch it to stereo. Now we're kind of boosting some of that low end in the room. It's kind of hard to hear. Here's mid only. So now you feel all that brightness on the kick and the snare. If I put it on side only, you're gonna feel it go to the hi-hats or hi-hat room cymbals. Back to mid. Back to side, back to stereo. For the longest time, I didn't know that the channel EQ was capable of mid-side processing. The fact that that's there in the channel EQ is kind of a big deal. That's great. That's so much bang for your buck on this free plugin. The last thing to note is just this little drop-down arrow right here, and this will affect the analyzer decay time. So if you want that analyzer like bumping like really fast, oops. Wrong way, really slow, here's really fast. You can see it springs back really quickly, or you can slow it down, kind of get a longer overtime picture of the sound. That's all preference, set it however you like, but it's there, hiding under that little dropdown. Finally, the last thing is this gain slider over here on the right. This is going to adjust the whole gain, just a volume knob for your EQ. So if you did a lot of crazy boosts and stuff, and sounds terrible, I wouldn't do that, but so here it is without the EQ. it's around 12 or minus 9 when I turn it on. Now it's pushing like minus 2. So then we would use this to pull it back down, kind of get something a little more balanced. So just a makeup gain. If you EQ out too much or add too much, you can adjust it right there. One final thing for this video is I want to show you the linear phase EQ because it's very similar. So what's really cool about the linear phase EQ is if you replace your EQ plugin with it, it'll bring those EQ curves over. So now you see we've switched to the linear phase EQ, but we have the same curves on our EQ. That's really cool that you can just switch the plugins and keep your EQ curves. Linear phase EQ does exactly what it says, and it uses more processing to preserve the phase of your EQ moves. So sometimes when you're doing lots of cuts and boosts, you can actually change the phase relationship of certain channels and certain instruments. And so the linear phase EQ is going to preserve that. It takes a little more processing, and it could, if you're doing big boosts and stuff, like it could start to mess with your transients. So just be a little careful with it. But this is especially good for mastering because it'll preserve the phase of your mix that you worked so hard for. I didn't think this was worth a whole separate video because all of the controls are the same. It's just something different going on in the back end. That about wraps up the video. If you enjoyed it or have any other questions, let me know down in the comments. Also, please be sure to like and subscribe. We'll see you on the next one.